Democrats in Tenino, Washington. You are on the air, Senator Sanders.
Oh, hi. Hello. Today is the Post Office Union's National Day of Action to stop delaying America's mail. And I'm putting a petition on change.org today to say, President Obama, please appoint people who support the Post Office to its Board of Governors. I'm wondering if you'd be able to sign, Senator, and ask your supporters to sign my petition.
Well, I certainly support your petition. I personally kind of stay away from petitions myself, but it's important that we understand, and I thank you, Florence, for what you're doing. The Postal Service is one of the important institutions in our country in terms of our economy and in terms of providing hundreds and hundreds of thousands of decent-paying jobs to American workers, including many veterans who work for the Postal Service. And let me just repeat what I've said many, many times. Every time you open up the paper and they talk about the finances of the Postal Service, they talk about the Postal Service being losing billions of dollars a year. What everybody should understand is that in terms of their operating budget, the Postal Service actually makes money. This year, I believe in the last year, they made something like $200 million. Not a lot of money, but it's a small profit. The reason they're in the red is because of this onerous legislation passed during the Bush administration, which requires the United States Postal Service to do what no other entity in the United States, in government, private sector, anywhere, or in the world does, and that is come up with 75 years of future retiree health care benefits in a 10-year period, costing about $5.5 billion every single year. So that's why they are in deficit, strictly because of that. If you eliminate that onerous requirement, they are actually making a profit. And in my view, what we have to do is give them the tools to make even more money and to be even more relevant here in the 21st century. So, Florence, I very much appreciate what you're doing. We have worked with all of the unions in trying to strengthen the Postal Service, see it grow. We are vigorously opposed and hope to do something in the next couple of weeks to prevent the closure of 82 processing plants around the country, which will only slow mail delivery and result in the loss of some 15,000 jobs.
Wow. Michelle.